Good morning, students. Today in this video we will talk about rounding numbers. Now, what is the meaning of rounding? Rounding means to tell the closer number to the other number. Whatever number is asked to you, that is closer to the other number or not, right? Let me give you an example. If you are buying something from outside, okay, from a mall, suppose you have purchased a compass box, right? The next day if your friend is asking you about the price of that compass box because he or she liked it so much, what you will do, you will tell the approximate price of that compass box to your friend. Why? Because you have not paid it, so you don't know exactly the price of it. You may tell that it was nearby 250 or 300. I don't know the exact price, I have to ask to my parents, right? That is called nearby. It may happen sometimes you don't know exactly the things, so you are guessing it and telling the approximate numbers to other person, right? If I ask you how many number of chocolates you have ate yesterday, you may tell 1, 2 or 5, whatever you have eaten. But if I ask you how many rotis you have ate, you may tell again 1, 2 or whatever number of rotis you have eaten. But if I ask you how many number of grains you have eaten, rice grains you have eaten in your rice, right? What you will tell? That how can I tell, madam, right? You don't know number of rice because we are not going to count. Even I am not counting while eating rice grain, right? But you approximate, if you have to write there, what you will do? You will approximate tell that I have taken one bowl. It may be 100 pieces of grain of rice in that. Like that you will explain, you will tell approximate number of that. So when the things are not very much clear, you may tell the nearby number to the other person. Rounding off means the same way, you are telling, you are guessing and telling the approximate number to the other person, right? Now if we talk about rounding up to the nearest tens, today we will learn about nearest 10 also and nearest 100 also, okay? Just now I am explaining about nearest 10. Nearest 10, then what you will do in this? First of all, it is nearest 10, so you have to remember the multiples of 10. Multiples of 10 means the answer of tens table. That is, what is tens? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. These are called tens, okay? Now, any number, one more thing, the middle number of it. Middle number of 10 and 20 is 15. Middle number of this is 25. 30 and 40 middle number, 35. 40 and 50, 45. Here 55. 60, 70, 65. 70, 80, 75. 80, 90, 85. And 90 and 100, 95, right? These are the middle numbers of all these tens. Okay, now let us move to the question. Suppose you are given the question, you have to find the round 58 to nearest 10. You have to round 58 to nearest 10. Now what you have to see, this 58 is in between which tens? So 50 and 60. It is between 50 and 60. Okay, so here you may write 50 and 60. What is the middle number of it? Middle number of 50 and 60 is 55. Now 58 is bigger than 55. So it will be near to 60. So your answer will be 60. This is one method to remember it. Okay. The another method is how to know whether it is between 50 and 60. For that, what you will do? What you will do is, first digit is 5. Okay. So 50. And the next number is 60. So 58 is between 50 and 60. Now after 5, this is 10's place. This is 1's place. Okay. We are going to do 10. So we have to see the 10's place only every time. So at 10's place it is 5. At 10's place it is 5. See the next number to it, that is 8. If the next number after 10's place, means at 1's place, if the digit is 5, 5, that is 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. If second digit is 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4, any one from this, then you don't have to do anything to 5. Just write 5 as it is and keep 0 back sign. Okay. Let me give you an example, that is 52. Okay. 5 is at 10th place and 2 is smaller than 5. Okay. So, you have to write, it is near to 50, so you have to write 50. This is the other method to remember. One more thing is that, say that these are strong numbers and these are weak numbers. Means this have power to push them to the next digit, but this does not have any power to push the other number. Okay, so now let me give you one more example. 68. Sorry, wait, we have already done. 67. Right? As we are talking about tens, at tens place 6 is given. So move to the next number, that is 7, and circle it. Why you have circled it? To decide whether 7 is the strongest number or weak number. It is the strongest number. So it has a power to push 6 to the next number. And to next number, when you will push, it will go to 7. From 6, it will move to 7, and here it will remain 0. So 67 is rounded to 70. Same way, another example, if I give you 73, right? Again, we are talking about tens place. So tens place 7 is given. Go to the next place to see whether the number is strong or weak. 3 is a weak number, okay? So it does not have power to push 7. It does not have power to push 7. So 7 will remain as it is over here. And instead of this, you will write 0. So 73 is rounded up to 70. Is that clear? This is the way how you can round numbers.